Hi students, welcome back to my channel. In this video I have solved important problems on solubility product and molar solubilities of salts by simplest and shortcut methods. Enjoy this video and do subscribe to my channel. A precipitate of silver chloride is formed when equal volumes of the following mix are mixed. What they have mixed? Silver nitrate and HCl of different concentrations are mixed in four different manner. And under which condition silver nitrate will precipitate out has to be determined. They have given the solubility product. KSP is called a solubility product for silver chloride as 1 × 10⁻¹. So this is from this data you have to find out which concentration will make this silver chloride to come out very easily, right? So how the reaction takes place? The reaction is between silver nitrate and HCl. And it gives silver chloride. Silver nitrate solution reacts with HCl, so hydrochloric acid to give silver chloride precipitate with the formation of nitric acid. So now here we have to find out which concentration is ideal to get the silver chloride easily from the mixture of this, right? So for that, let us take this saturated solution of silver chloride, right? So saturated solution of sparingly soluble salt like silver chloride. So here silver chloride is a sparingly soluble salt. That is, small amount of silver chloride is soluble in the water. Now what we prepared here is a saturated solution of sparingly soluble salt. That means we have taken water and to that silver chloride is added. When you add initially, first silver chloride will dissolve and dissociate into ions as silver and chloride ion. I keep on adding silver chloride. It dissolves and then dissociates. Continue the addition of silver chloride. At one stage, added silver chloride will not dissolve. It remains as a solid. And that condition is called as equilibrium conditions. Under that solid silver chloride will be in equilibrium with its ions in the solution. The solid in the saturated solution will be in equilibrium with its ions. So for this equilibrium, if you read the equilibrium expression, equilibrium constant K is equal to molar concentrations of products to that of the salt, reactant. The reactant is a salt, it is a solid, so concentration of solid is taken as 1. So then this KSP will become, KSP becomes product of molar concentrations of the products. Here in this case Ag plus and Cl minus, they are the molar concentration of silver and chloride ions. So KSP, right, is this equilibrium constant and it is called as the solubility product. So that is related to free energy change as minus delta G is equal to minus RT into ln KP KSP plus RT into ln Q. Then what Q and KSPs are? KSP is already known, I already told you that. It is a solubility product, right? It is an equilibrium constant and that is equal to concentrations of Ag plus and Cl minus at the equilibrium. Then Q will be called as ionic product, product of ions at a given time, at a given time. So that is equal to the concentration of ions, right, present there. It is a product of the ions, or the product of the ions present in the solution, right? So here, how this KSP and Q are related? Let us see that. If Q, that is ionic product, is less than the KSP, that means if these ions are less than the KSP, that means the product side is less. So when this is concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus is less, according to Li-Shetley's principle, what happens? More and more silver chloride dissolves. So here, since when the concentration of these ions are less, according to Li-Shetley's principle, more and more silver chloride dissolves. That means salt dissolves under that conditions. If it is reversed, if Q is greater than KSP, that means if the concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus ions are more, that the concentration of ions are more, the concentration of products are more than the reactant, then according to Li-Shetley's principle, reverse reaction takes place. Reverse reaction is combination of ionic solutions to give the solid, and that is called as precipitation or salt separation. So if the concentration of ions, that is ionic product, is more than the solubility product, salt will precipitate. So that is what is expected here. What should be the condition is the concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus ion should be greater than the solubility product, right? So that is what is important. Concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus should be greater than KSP, right? If Q is equal to KSP, neither precipitation nor dissolution takes place. So this is the basis for this problem. So these are the theoretical aspects on which these problems are been designed. So using this, solve the problem. So what should be the condition for the precipitation? Q should be greater than solubility product KSP. KSP is given, that is KgCl is equal to 1 into 10 raised to minus 10. So Q should be greater than KS3. So Q is product of 8 silver ions and chloride ions. So here silver and chloride ion will come from silver nitrate and HCl. So they are strong electrolyte. So that means concentration of Hg plus and Cl minus will be equivalent to concentration of silver nitrate and chloride ion. So see that. So this should be greater than the solubility product. So under which conditions this is greater? Let us verify one by one. First case. So concentrations, it is 10 raised to minus 4 silver nitrate concentration, 10 raised to minus 7 is HCl concentration. So product of that is, since the bases are same, simply add the powers of it, minus 4 minus 7 is minus 11. 10 raised to minus 11 is less than 10 raised to minus 10, that is the solubility product. So that means Q is less than the KSP. If Q is less than the KSP, dissolution of the salt takes place. This is not the precipitation, it is dissolution. Now let us take the second one. It is also 10 raised to minus 5 and minus 11, 6, minus 5, minus 6 is minus 11. That is also less than the KSP. Here also dissolution takes place. Now let us take the third one, minus 5 and minus 4. So minus 9, 10 raised to minus 9 is greater than 10 raised to minus 10. So that means Q is greater than the KSP that has been achieved here. So that means under these conditions, when the concentration of AgNO3 is 10 raised to minus 5 and HCl is 10 raised to minus 4, precipitation do have take place. Now last one, so just add out this and find out minus 6, minus 6, minus 12. So here also dissolution takes place because Q is less than KSP. So this is the answer. C is the answer. So that means 10 raised to minus 5 silver nitrate and 10 raised to minus 4 mole HCl will result in the precipitation of HCl easily. So this is a very important question. So most of the questions will be on the solubility product and the solubility. We will discuss the solubility later. Right? So let us see the problem similar to this. Right. So there is another problem appeared in 2011 of KCET. H2S passed into 1 nanometer cube. Don't worry about the volume of it. So what we need is the solution concentration. So of 1 nanometer of the solution containing 0.1 mole of Zn plus ion and 0.01 moles of cupric ion till the sulfate ion concentration reaches to 8.9 into 10 raised to minus 19 moles. Which one of the following statement is true? KSP of ZnS and CuS are 3 into 10 raised to minus 22 and 8 into 10 raised to minus 36 respectively. So you see the difference, minus 22 and minus 36 for the cupric sulfide. So only ZnS precipitate, copper sulfate precipitate, both ZnS and copper sulfate precipitate, no precipitation occurs. So it is again same. So Q should be greater than KSP for the precipitation. So that means ionic product must be greater than the solubility product. So ions of concentration is given. So that is zinc ion and sulfate ion is there. So take the product. So here it is 0.1. Convert into 10 raised to the power. So 0.1 is 10 raised to minus 1. For zinc sulfate, zinc and sulfate is 10 raised to minus 19. First add the powers of the 10. Minus 10 raised to minus 19, 10 raised to minus 1. So that becomes 10 raised to 20. So 8.1 times 10 raised to 20. 10 raised to 20 is greater than 10 raised to 22. So that means Q is greater than the 10 KSP. So then thus zinc sulfide precipitates. That's done. Now come to copper. Next, copper is 0.01, that is 10 raised to minus 2. And that of sulfide is minus 19. Minus 2 minus 19 is minus 21. 8.1 times the 10 raised to minus 21. 10 raised to minus 21 is much greater than 10 raised to 36. Here also Q is greater than KSP. So that means copper and zinc both will get precipitated out. So both get precipitated out. So this is the answer. So this type of questions would be expected in the examination. This is a very important question. Right? These type of questions are normally been asked in the competitive examination. The KSP for the following reaction dissociation is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 5 for the lead chloride dissociated to give Pb2 plus and C2Cl minus. Which of the following choices is correct for the mixture of 300 ml of 0.134 molar lead nitrate and 100 ml of 0.4 molar NaCl? Not enough data. Q is greater than KSP, Q is less than KSP, Q is equal to KSP. It is a relationship between ionic product and solubility product. Solubility product is given, concentration of ions are given. It is similar to the previous example, right? So do it for yourself. Okay. So concentrations, right? Find out the concentration, the number of equivalents, that will be volume into the molarity. So here find out what is that. Here 1 mole of
lead nitrate reacts with two moles of NaCl. That's what you have to know, right? So write properly. So here that corresponds. Actually, they have given only this, right? So this product of this, that will be the concentration of the chloride ion. So take that and take the product of it and see whether Q is less than or greater than or equal to KSP. Right, that's what you have to identify. Do it for yourself. Next question, which has appeared in APMT. Gibbs spin energy change, delta G naught is equal to plus 63.3 kilojoules for the following reaction. Reaction is given. KSP for this reaction is at in water at 25 degrees. So much that we have to find out, right? So here the formula to be used is, it is at equilibrium, so that means it is only delta G naught is equal to minus RT into ln KP. So convert into natural logarithm. So multiply by 2.303 logarithm to base 10, natural logarithm to logarithm to base 10. So then simplify for R and T. T is 25 minus 298 Kelvin. R, since this is in kilojoules, right, to convert this into joules. So multiply this by 1000. And R will be 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole, right? So simplify that. And please remember this, product of 2.303 into 8.314 into 298. Because under standard conditions, the product of this will be 5705.8. So delta G naught divided by 5705.8 is equal to log K. Right, so take the find out the value, this negative value, and take the anti logarithm, then you get the KSP. Right, so the highlighted value will be the value of our correct answer for this. If the solubility product of zirconium phosphate is denoted by KSP and its molar solubility is denoted by S, then which of the following relation between S and KSP is correct? They have shown the relationship between S and KSP, right? Now which one is correct, that has to be determined. Now for this I will tell you the simplest way so that you can answer the answer this type of questions for any salts, right? Here instead of zirconium I have taken A, this instead of 3 it is X ion, X number, and phosphate instead of phosphate it is B and Y type, Y number of phosphate ion, that is B ion. Now with this sparingly soluble salt, the AXBY will be in equilibrium with X moles of A and Y moles of B ion, right? And what is the charge of A and B, right? Now I will tell you the simplest way, right? AX by BY, AX BY is the salt. Here the foot of the B will become the head of the A, that is Y plus first always, right, plus ion. And the foot of A will become the head of the B, that is X minus ion, right? So here number of ions are not important, ions, the charge of the ions are not important, but number of that ion is important here, right? Now for this, solubility product is equal to molar concentration of products, that is ion is A to the power X into a B, ion B to the power Y, right? So here, instead of the concentration, right, we express in terms of solubility, S be the, let S be the solubility of X by BY in water. Then, here look at this, S is the solubility of this. Here what is the coefficient of X by Y? What is the, now this will, one mole will give X moles of A and Y moles of B. So here S coefficient is 1, so here it's 1. Here the ions is X times of S, here coefficient of this is 1, 1S. Coefficient of this is X times of S. Coefficient of B ion is Y times of S. So this is the solubility of this ion, this is the product of that, right, of the solubility S is equal to, will be in relationship in this manner. Now, the concentration of this ion is equal to S. But how many types of ions are, how many ions are there? X times of S, right? X times of S, right? So that S will be equal to X times of S. Similarly, B ion is equal to S, the concentration that is equal to S. So simplified here, KSP is equal to X into S to the power of X and Y into S to the power of Y. So product of molar concentration of A ion into Y concentrations of Y ion. So here the concentration is equal to X times of S, right? So because S is equal to concentration of that particular ion. Then on simplification, this becomes, KSP becomes X to the power of X into Y to the power of Y into S to the power of X plus Y, right? I repeat again. So this is the simplest way of expressing the solubility product, and this will shows the relationship between the solubility product KSP and S. So KSP is equal to X to the power of X into Y to the power of Y multiplied by S, that is solubility product, to the power S X plus Y, where X and Y are the number of cation and anions in the salt. Now for this salt, this is 3 moles of zirconium ion and 4 moles of phosphate ions are there. X is equal to 3 here and Y is equal to 4 here. So Ksp is equal to X, that is 3 to the power of 3 into 4 to the power of 4 multiplied by S to the power of 3 plus 4. That is the Ksp value. Simplify this. 3 into 3 into 3 is 27, and 4 to the power of 4 is 4 square is equal to 16. The 4 to the power of 4 can be written as 4 square into 4 square. 4 square is 16. 16 to 16 is 256. That is simplest way. Now here 6 into 7 is 42. So here the last number is 2. In which equation it is 2? Find out. It is there here. No, it's not in other equation it is not there. So this itself is clue. 6912 is the answer. Right? If you multiply, you get 6912. S is equal to Ksp by 6912. Since it is S to the power of 7, the value is S is equal to Ksp upon 6912 whole to the power 1/7. Right? So this is the simplest way of writing the solubility product or expressing the solubility product in terms of solubility of the material. Right? So this is one of the important question that could be expected in the examination. And so remember, Ksp is equal to x to the power of x into y to the power of y multiplied by s to the power of x plus y, where x and y are the number of cation and anions in the salt. Now let us see. So this is for silver chloride, x and y is equal to 1. So the 1 square, 1 to the power of 1, 1 to the power of 1 is 1 again. So the Ksp is equal to s square. So just one another example, the simplest example. Next, another question appeared in JWE 2001. Sparingly soluble salt A times P, AP, BQ, the relationship of its solubility product and solubility is. Now here instead of X and Y, it is P and Q is there. So as I told you, it is X to the power of X here, P to the power of P into Q to the power of Q multiplied by S into S to the power of P plus Q. S to the power of P plus Q into P to the power of P, Q to the power of Q. So this is the relationship between solubility product and the solubility, that is molar solubility. So this is one of the very important question that you can expect in the examination. The Ksp of silver chromate is, silver chromate AgCl, AgBr, AgAr respectively 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 12, 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 10, 5 into 10 raised to minus 11, 13 and 8.3 into 10 raised to minus 17. Which one of the following salts will precipitate last if silver nitrate solution is added to the solution containing equal volumes of sodium chloride, sodium bromide, sodium iodide and sodium chromate? So when silver nitrate is made to react with NaCl, NaBr, NaI and sodium chromate, so the salts of that will precipitate out and that will be sparingly insoluble. So that will be precipitate. So which one will precipitate last is the question. Now here I will tell you the simplest means, right? So here look at this. Same number of anions and cations are there, AgCl, AgBr, AgI. If this is given, then you could have easily tell, you can easily tell by knowing the solubility product. What is the condition? If the salt are having the high solubility, the salt having higher solubility will be precipitated lost. So the name itself says it is a solubility product. So if the solubility product is higher, that means it will be soluble. If it is lower, it will not be so easily soluble. That means it can precipitate out. So among these, AgCl, AgBr, AgI, AgI will precipitate out first. Then comes AgBr, that is 10 raised to minus 13. 10 raised to minus 10 is more than 10 raised to minus 13, which is more than that of 10 raised to minus 17. So here it is 8.3 times, here 5 times and 1.8 times. So that means I can simply take this, right? So 10 raised to minus 10, because anyway this is 5 times of this and it is more 8 times of it. So that means this silver chloride is more soluble, that means it will be precipitated last than this. But we don't know about the silver chromate because number of ions present here is 2 silver ions and 1 chromate ion. Now if you compare these two, silver chloride and silver chromate, then it is easier, right? So that means if this has less solubility than silver chloride, then this silver chromate will precipitate last. Or if it is less than AgCl, then AgCl will precipitate last. So let us compare these two, right? So for that, take silver chromate. So what is that you have to represent in terms of solubility? So you have to find out the solubility of it. So solubility, how it is related? So here XII is 2 and Y is CrO4, this is a single ion, Y is 1. So find out the solubility. So solubility product is equal to S to the X, the X to the power of X, that is 2 to the power of 1, 2, and Y is 1, 1 to the power of 1 into S to the power of X plus Y. So that will come down to 4 into S to the power of 3. So that means S is equal to 4S cube is equal to KSP, or S is equal to cube root of KSP by 4. What is KSP? KSP for Sulokumat is 10 raised to minus 12 by into 1.1. Substitute there. So here 4.1.1 divided by 4, keep it like that. So cube root, take the cube root for 10 raised to minus 12. Minus 12 divided by 3. Cube root is minus 12 divided by 3. So 12 by 3 is minus 4. So 10 raised to minus 4, keep this as it is. So square root of 1.1 into 4. So this is 10 raised to minus 4. What about this one? This is which one? HCl is 10 raised to minus 10. So if you take that, that is S square. So square root of that, simplify that. So when you simplify, it becomes S value will be Ksp is equal to S square. That is, if the number of ions are 2, you simply take the square root of it. If it is 3, number of ions are 3, then what is that you have to do is, so that is 2 square, that is 3, 2 square into the number of ions, right? You have to take X and Y and find out that, right? So if it is 2, it is very simple. So that will be equal to Ksp is equal to S square, or S is equal to square root of Ksp. So Ksp is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 10. Take the square root for 10 raised to minus 10. So that is 10 raised to minus 10 divided by 2. That is 10 raised to minus 5 into square root of 1.8. Keep it. Now look at this. 10 raised to minus 5 here, whereas 10 raised to minus 4. So you then this will come. Now this can be taken as either it is 1 between 1 and 2. Here it is square root of 1 by 8. So 1 by 8, 1.8 can be taken as 2. If you take it as square root of 2, right? Now here it is 1.3 times. Now here it is, how much is that? Even if you take it as 1, 1 by 4 is 1 by 2, square root of 1 by 4 is 1 by 2. So even in that case, this is more than 10 raised to minus 4 is more than 10 raised to minus 5. So here, even if you neglect this one, right? So this is, if you take, even if both are almost, actually this is lesser than this. This is, even if you take it as this as 2 and this also as a 2, right? If it, 2 by 4 is half of it. So then square root of that, whereas this is square root of 2, whereas this is square root of 1 by 2, that is half of this, almost half of it, right? So that means it is still more than that of HCl. So in this case, silver chromate has higher solubility than silver chloride. That means silver chromate will be precipitated last. So then other things you can simply find out square root of Ksp is 10 raised to, how much is that? Minus 30. So this can be written as 15 to 10 raised to minus 4. So that will be 10 raised to minus 7 into square root of 50. 50 can be written as 49. So 49 is 7 square, right? 7 sevens are, right? Okay, that you can take that, right? So that is 7 times of this. So even if it is that 7 times, that is lesser than this one, the silver chloride. And the silver iodide is, if you simplify this, this will be square root of 10 raised to 8.3 into 10 raised to 17, or this is 83 into 10 raised to minus 18, minus 18 by 2 is 9, so 10 raised to minus 9, square root of 83, so the nearest number is 81, that is 9 square, right? Okay, so from that 9 square, that is 9 times of this, almost, I should say. So from that, you can easily tell which one will precipitate last. So this is another important type of question that you can expect in this case, right? Okay, so if it is only HCl, HBr, AgR, by looking at the Ksp itself, you can tell. So condition is the salt having higher solubility product will, solubility will be precipitated at higher solubility, right? So here, instead of S, here by taking solubility itself, X, right? Of course, indirectly it is same, right? So solubility of silver chromate is more. So hence, this will precipitate at last. So which one will precipitate at first? Silver iodide is the first. Then comes silver chromate, then silver chloride, then silver chromate. So first is AgI, last is Ag2CrO4, that is silver chromate. A solution which is 10 raised to minus 3 mole each in manganese, ferrous, zinc and mercuric ion is treated with 10 raised to minus 16 moles of sulfide ion. If Ksp of MnS, manganese sulfide, ferrous sulfide, zinc sulfide, mercuric sulfide are 10 raised to minus 15, minus 23, minus 20 and minus 54, respectively, which one will precipitate out first? So this is opposite of the previous question.
So there what they have asked is which one precipitate out last, right? Because there the condition was the salt having higher solubility will be precipitated last. So that was the previous question. Here it is opposite of it. What they have asked is which one will precipitate out first. So what is the condition here? The shortcut method is salt having lower solubility will be precipitated first. If you see that 10 raised to minus 54 for mercury. So this is the lowest solubility material. So that means mercuric sulfide will be precipitated out first. So how it will be determined? So you find out how much sulfide ion is required for the precipitation, whether it's less amount is required or more amount. If you calculate using the same Ksp is equal to products of molar concentrations of metal ion and anion. So metal ion is here, you take for mercuric sulfide, that is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 because all these are same concentration. Substitute for Ksp for this mercuric sulfide, that will be 10 raised to minus 54. 10 raised to minus 54 divided by 10 raised to minus 3. So minus 3 will come to numerator, minus 54 plus the 3 means minus 51. That means the amount of sulfide required is 10 raised to minus 51 moles. Very, very small amount of sulfide is required. So within small amount of sulfide that is added to this, it will be precipitated out, right? So hence the precipitation is fast with mercuric ion compared to other, right? Because others will be in the order of 20 or less than 20, whereas here it is more than double than this, right? Okay, so that is the shortcut method. Remember, salt having higher solubility will be precipitated last, salt having lower solubility will be precipitated first. So remember this part. Next, another question, 1 dm cube of solution containing 10 raised to minus 5 moles of chloride and chromate ions is treated with 10 raised to minus 4 moles of silver nitrate. So chloride chromate ion is given, anions, and the silver ion, that is cation, is given, right? Concentrations of these are given. Which one of the following statement observation is made? Right here, Ksp for the chromate and the chloride is given. Precipitation does not occur. Silver chromate gets precipitated first. Silver chloride precipitated first, or silver chromate get precipitated first, or both silver chromate chloride start precipitating simultaneously. Again, this is already been discussed in the previous case. There you have told that salts having higher solubility will be precipitated last. We found out that silver chromate is the one which is having higher solubility, hence it will precipitate out last, right? So after that comes chloride, then comes bromide, then comes iodate, right? So that means iodate will precipitate out first, then bromide, then chloride, then silver chromate. This will be precipitated last. So here from that itself you can say that silver chloride will be precipitated first. Or if you calculate, so by the ionic product, see that in which case ionic product is more than solubility product. For silver chloride, ionic product is more than Ksp, so that would mean silver chloride will precipitate out as per this. Next, if you take the same ions concentration which is given there and substitute for chromate, then what you get here is Q, that is ionic product, is less than solubility product, hence silver chromate dissolves, whereas silver chloride will precipitate first. So remember the previous example, and that will be a clue for this type of questions, right? So since these are all the practical problems, right, so you can the values will be same. What is the molar solubility of aluminium hydroxide in 0.2 molar sodium hydroxide solution given that solubility product of aluminium hydroxide is equal to 2.4 into 10 raised to minus 24? So they have given the solubility product. They asked you to calculate the molar solubility of aluminium hydroxide is 0.2 molar sodium hydroxide. So now this is submitted in JW 2019. So normal way of doing it is, right, you know the number of ions which are present there, directly do that. So Ksp and relationship between Ksp and S is, so number of ions is 1 positively charged ion and 3 hydroxyl negatively charged ions are there. So according to this equation, x to the power of x, that is 1 to the power of 1, into y to the power of y, that is 3 to the power of 3, into s to the power of x plus 1, that is x plus y, that is 1 plus 3. So 3 to the 1 to the power of 1 is 1, 3 to the power of 3 into s to the power of 3 plus 1, that is equal to 27 into s to the power of 4. Or s is equal to Ksp by 27 to the power 1 by 4, right? So here this is for the solubility of the material in water. But what they are asking, molar solubility of the material in sodium hydroxide solution. So here, in presence of sodium hydroxide, we have to determine the
molar solubility of aluminum hydroxide. So what is so special about it is, so here sodium hydroxide, when it is there in solution, it dissociates completely to give Na plus and OH minus ion. So this OH minus ion is common with the hydroxyl ion of the aluminum hydroxide. So there is a common ion effect. Because of this common ion effect, this is a strong electrolyte, dissociates completely, whereas this is sparingly soluble salt and it is in equilibrium. Once OH minus is added to this, the equilibrium will be disturbed. So concentration of hydroxyl ion on the product side increases. So there will be application of Le Chatelier's principle. So what will happen? So because of the increase in concentration, so this equilibrium will shift towards left. So it has to nullify. Le Chatelier's principle has to nullify. According to that, it has to nullify the change. So that means more and more hydroxyl ion combines with Al plus ion, Al3 plus ion to give back aluminum hydroxide. So there will be decrease in the concentration of hydroxyl ion due to aluminum hydroxide. The presence of OH minus of the sodium hydroxide suppresses this dissociation of aluminum hydroxide, and thus there may be very less amount of hydroxyl and aluminum ion. So if it is, if without this, there would have been 3 hydroxyl ion and 1 aluminum ion. But the amount of hydroxyl ion is less, we don't know how much it is, so definitely it is not possible to tell the concentration of aluminum. So then in such cases, right, so what is the concentration of hydroxyl ion? That is equal to the hydroxyl ion obtained from the sodium hydroxide, because it is a strong electrolyte. So how much is that? That is equal to 0.2 molar. So NaOH hydroxyl ion concentration is equal to concentration of NaOH, that is equal to 0.2 molar, right? So now then the concentration of Al2 plus, let it be equal to X. So we know the KSP, that is solubility product. Substitute in the expression, right, KSP is equal to concentration of aluminum 2 into concentration of hydroxyl ion to the power 3. So substitute that, X is the aluminum concentration of aluminum, KSP is known, hydroxyl ion, that is under this condition. So calculate that. So on simplification, right, this can be written as 10 raised to minus 24 can be written as 24 into 10 raised to minus 25 divided by, this can be written as 8 into 10 raised to minus 3. Simplify this, we will be getting 3 into 10 raised to minus 22. 24 by 8 is 3, minus 25 plus 3 is, when it comes goes to numerator, it becomes plus 3. So this becomes minus 22. K is X is equal to 3 into 10 raised to minus 22, right? So this is the solubility of the material in presence of solubility of what? Aluminum hydroxide in presence of sodium hydroxide. So in presence of the strong electrolyte, there is a decrease in the dissociation. This can be determined. So this is another important type of question that could be expected in the examination, right? Okay. Another question, right? Of course, it has also appeared in JEE 2019, right? Okay. So molar solubility of cadmium hydroxide is 1.84 into 10 raised to minus 5 molar in water. So that is solubility of material in water is given, right? The expected solubility of cadmium hydroxide in buffer solution of pH is equal to 12 is how much? That is, instead of pH 12 means POH 2, that is equal to 10 raised to minus 2 is the hydroxyl ion concentration. So here hydroxyl ion concentration is given, same, here it is buffer. So what is that they have given? They have given the molar solubility, that is, yes, this is given. So from this calculate KSP, so you will come to know the KSP of it. Hydroxyl ion is given here. So from that you can calculate the concentration of the cadmium. So that is equal to the solubility of it. That is equal to S. That itself will be the solubility of the material in what? In that, in this buffer, that is 12. So here concentration of solubility as well of solubility is measured in presence of hydroxyl. So here also same thing. Same as this. First find out the KSP using molar solubility, that is S. Using the similar formula, here number of ions are 3, whereas here it is 4. So 1 to the power of 1 into 2 to the power of 2 into S to the power of 1 plus 2, that is 3. So from that you can calculate the KSP. From that KSP, follow the same method and you will get the answer. The KSP of silver chromate is 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 12 at 298 Kelvin. So KSP of silver chromate is given. Solubility of age silver chromate in 0.1 molar silver nitrate is so much. So it is quite similar to the previous one. In the previous case, hydroxyl ion has been sodium hydroxide in presence of anion is given. Here common ion, there in the previous case anion is a common ion, here Ag plus ion is a common ion. You can do this problem. So we'll go to the next question. The next question is solubility product product constant KSP of the salts of type MX, MX2 and M3X at a temperature T are. So solubility product values are given here. respectively. Solubilities of the salts, temperature, salts at temperature T are in the order. Normally, so to do this, the best way to find out the solubility is, solubility is equal to S is equal to square root of, right, that is equal to square root of x plus y root times k, root times a ksp by x to the power of x into y to the power of y. So what you do is, for the ksp value, see the number of ions present there. See, if there are 2, divide that by the power to be divided by the 2. If it is 3 2 plus 1, so 3, divide that by 3. So if it is 4 3 plus 1 4 ions, minus 5, 15 by 4. So this will give an idea about it. So generally, if the number of ions are more, solubility value will be less. If the number of ions are more, then what will happen is the solubility will be less. No, but here the care which you have to take is, right, here the realistic value is given. So for this mx2 to m3x, the number value is almost the same, right? It is not so that much different. It's only 10 times difference. So calculate as per this, and from that you can easily make out, right? Okay. You can easily find out the answer. So this is the formula. So just find out the number of ions. X is equal to first anion, cation. Y is equal to number of anions. So ksp is given, x to the power of x and y to the power of y. Find out, and you can keep this as it is, and take the simplify this ksp value. From that you can easily make out which one is having the order can be easily determined. In a qualitative analysis, in order to detect the second group basic radical, H2S gas is passed in presence of dilute HCl. So H2S is a weak acid, and to the, that will be passed into the solution in presence of dilute acid, right? So here the common ion is H plus and H plus ion. Common ion effect says that if there is any common ion, dissociation of weak acid decreases. It will decrease the dissociation of H2S. So as a result, number of sulfate ion in the solution will be less, right? So here increases, no, decreases the dissociation of salt, no, decreases this dissociation of H2S. C is the correct answer. So though it is a part of dissociation, common ion effect, hence it has been taken here. H2S is used in two groups, one is second group and as well as in fourth group. Fourth group, we should have more amount of sulfate ion. For that, the reaction will be done in presence of alkaline media, right? That is in presence of ammonium hydroxide. So it will increases the dissociation of H2S, right? So there it requires more of sulfide, whereas for the second group it requires less of sulfide. Hi friends, thank you very much. Please ask questions in comment section, and like this video, share with your friends, and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.